Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the future updates. Hello everyone. In this part of the video, we are going to see the topic of sources of Hindu law. So what are the various kinds or what are the various sources regarding Hindu law? And on this topic, what will be the questions asked in the question paper? It will be describe the sources of Hindu law or what are the various sources of Hindu law. Questions asked: 1. What are the sources of Hindu law? 2. State the various sources of Hindu law. As for the introduction of the topic, we can say that Hindu religion is the most ancient religion and therefore it has evolved through time, and still there are few things which are definitely certain which have force of law, and therefore we have to see that what is the source of Hindu law, and that's why this will be the introduction part basically. Now proceeding with the answer, as far as sources of Hindu law are concerned, we can divide it into three parts. Firstly Shrutis, then Smritis, and then custom. So these three will be the primary sources of Hindu law, and we will deal with one by one in detail. Sources of Hindu law: Shruti, Smriti, custom. First source was Shruti. Now even though the word says Shruti, actually it is Vedas, and Vedas is the most primary source. Veda is knowledge given by the God Almighty to the human mankind. And this is what has been perceived by the Rishis and Munis during the pre-ancient era, and that is what the Vedas are all about. There are four kinds of Vedas: Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sam Ved, and Atharva Ved. And each Ved deals with the different aspects of human life. Shruti, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, and Atharva Ved. The next important source is Smriti. Now Smriti itself states that it is a memory. Since in pre-ancient era, writing was not evolved, and therefore knowledge was handed down to generations from generations by telling it in the voice. So from the memory, a previous generation used to pass on the knowledge to the next generation, and that's where Smritis evolved. As far as Smritis are concerned, the primary source of Smriti, basically the first Smriti which is available, is Manusmriti, which is basically the baseline of entire Hindu law. And Manusmriti incorporates various aspects and facets of Hindu religion and other various laws. Also, as far as Manusmriti is concerned, there is also Yajnavalkya Smriti, which has been given basically by Yajnavalkya Rishi. Then Narada Smriti and Kautilya Smriti, which is more recent one. Kautilya, who is basically Chanakya, we call it. That person has written many things as far as Arthashastra and concern, and other aspects of political science, and various laws have been evolved through time that has been incorporated by Kautilya in his Arthashastra book. Smriti, Manusmriti, Yajnavalkya Smriti, Narada Smriti, Kautilya Smriti. The third and the last important source of Hindu law is custom. Now, to understand custom, basically the main sentence is Achara Paramo Dharma, meaning what behavior or custom is the ultimate source of religion that has been evolved through time. So Achara Paramo Dharma, that's where the custom has evolved the force of law. The custom can be further divided into three parts. Firstly, it is a local custom in respect of specific region. Then it will be custom related to particular family, and then custom related to particular caste. So we can divide the part of custom into these three categories. But to get the force of law, few tests has to be taken as far as whether that custom will have a force of law or not. So custom, local custom, family custom, caste custom. There are few tests as far as custom is concerned, and then only we can say that custom can be treated as a source of law. What are those? First test is antiquity. So basically the test of time. If the custom is going on for a time period which is very much ancient, then only we can say that that custom has a force of law. The custom which has started with the new generation, that will not be a source of law, it will be a new custom. But still, as far as custom being a source of law, it has to be ancient. How much ancient it should be, there is no law per se, but it has to be certain period of time passed, and still that custom has passed the test of time, and then only it will get the force of law. The second test for a custom is certainty. So if the custom is certain, there is no ambiguity as far as following that custom is concerned, then only that custom can have force of law. If different people have different opinions over that custom and it is not certain at all, it will not be treated as a force of law. Still, it will be custom, but custom not having force of law. To have a force of law, that custom has to be a certain custom. The third test is reasonableness. So the custom should be morally reasonable, and then only that custom will have a force of law. If the custom is immoral, definitely that custom will not be treated as if it has a force of law. Let's take an example. There was a custom that if a husband dies, the widow shall go sati. Now that custom was treated as unreasonable and unlawful by enacting certain laws, and therefore after certain period of time when the laws were framed, basically when Britishers were ruling, at that time sati abolition law was framed, and thereafter that custom lost the reasonableness test, and therefore we don't follow that custom anymore because it is immoral custom. The fourth and the last test is continuity. So that custom has to follow continuously throughout the time, and then only it will get a force of law. This test is mostly applicable towards the custom related to particular caste or particular family. So for example, if a family is following certain custom, that custom has to be followed by all the generations in the family without a single interruption in it, and then only that custom will have effect of force of law. Why is this very much relevant that that custom should have a force of law? Because if you go through various enactments like Hindu Marriage Act for example, as far as degrees of prohibited relationship and sapinda relationship, if the custom allows it, then such marriage also will become valid marriage, otherwise that marriage is void marriage, and therefore to have that custom of force of law becomes very vital. Custom, 1. Antiquity, 2. Certainty, 3. Reasonableness, 4. Continuity. To conclude this topic, we can say that Hindu religion being very ancient, there are various sources of law wherein the religion has evolved and set down certain principles which have force of law. Those are Shrutis, Smritis and Custom. This conclusion will be sufficient if you write it in the answer sheet. Same video in Marathi language is also uploaded on YouTube, the link of which is given in the description box down below. If you have any queries or doubts, please ask them in the comment section, I will definitely answer to you. How to write the answer in the answer sheet? For that, I have uploaded sample answers on my blog. Please go through the link on the description box. You will get to know about it now.
If you have liked the video, please give a thumbs up. Video on various topics are going to be uploaded on YouTube. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for the future updates. Thank you.